Hello, there is no audio.
Yeah, is it started or
No,
we cannot?
it will start. It will start in two
Okay.
minutes. Yeah. Good morning, everyone. I hope my screen is visible to you all and my audio is clear to everyone, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So we'll start from here. So I'll start with an introduction about myself. I'm the host for this webinar. Myself, Rupesh. I'm working with the Synergetics as a digital strategist. So our today's webinar is all based on DevOps with Azure, DevSecOps with Azure DevOps. So before moving ahead with the webinar, I would like to give a small introduction about Synergetics, that is a company. This webinar is sponsored by Synergetics only. So Synergetics is an innovative company, which is primarily working in B2B and B2C segments, where we are having different training solutions to all the information technology professionals. So the solutions where we are primarily working are persona-based onboarding, reskilling solution, certification solution, emerging technology training, cloud adoption solution, and practice development. So our today's webinar is sponsored by Synergetics, and it is conducted by emerging technology community. So our community is open to all the people who are interested in cloud technologies, as well as the latest technologies like machine learning, big data, analytics, IoT, cloud, DevOps. If you guys are interested in these technologies, then you just have to do a small thing that you have to download an application called Meetup. And once you download the application, you can join, you can find the communities, which are emerging technology community. Azure Tech, emerging technology community is in Mumbai based and the common community for everyone. The other communities are location based, you can say. The other is Azure Tech community, Pune, for Pune people, Surat emerging. Hello. Please keep yourself on mute, guys. Then Surat emerging technology community, Azure Tech community, Nagpur, for Nagpur people, artificial intelligence, AI on Microsoft platform community for AI interested people. So this is a small code of conduct. Please take a note that you cannot take a screenshot and you cannot record this session. If you want the recordings, then we will be uploading these recordings on our YouTube channel. So do follow our YouTube channel. We'll be sharing the link in the chat box for your reference. One more important thing I want to share with you today. I want to share an important message with you all. Okay. So recently there was an incident happened which was related to our last webinar. There was an attendee whose name is Rasik Bapotra. He was an employee of a reputed company, Accenture, had contacted some of the other attendees and offered them a job option. So guys, please take a note that we have already blacklisted this person. And if anything that will be violating our policies, we'll be facing strict legal actions from this time onwards. So I'll request you all to join our session with a learning purpose. And please do not make such activities which are unprofessional. So from this time onwards, we'll be, you know, keep tracking all these things. So please do not violate the policies. So as I've said, so today's webinar is based on DevSecOps with Azure DevOps. And our session agenda is Azure DevOps quick overview, the four quadrants of security, code analysis with SonarQube, package scanning, white source bolt, scanning infrastructure with Azure Policy and Azure Monitor, container image scanning with Trevi. Our session takeaways will be understanding DevSecOps, security in CI and CD, third-party tools, services, for security in Azure pipelines. Please keep yourself on mute. Okay, so today's speaker for the webinar is Mr. Mahendra Sir. So he is a Microsoft certified trainer, and he's working as a training consultant technology lead for DevOps and Java practice at Synergetics. He worked on highly demanded corporate technologies like ALM, DevOps, principles, CI/CD design, patterns, infrastructure management and deployment using MS Azure, infrastructure, Chef, Puppet and Ansible. Today, he is also extensively working on Spring, Struts and Hibernate and other Java frameworks. So this is our training calendar for the month. Anyone who's interested in the trainings, they can contact me. I'll be sharing my contact number and WhatsApp number in the chat box. So our next certification webinar is based on PL100 topic, which is Introduction to Power Virtual Agent. And the date of the webinar is 24th of July. Session will be starting at 10 a.m. in the morning. If you are interested in the session, you can just register yourself. We'll be sharing all the links in the chat box. So keep checking the chat box, guys. So this is a webinar calendar for the year. So as I know, it's a long list, but yeah, one by one, we are going to announce it in every session. So as I've said already about the certification series webinar, the next webinar series that simultaneously we are running, it is based on emerging technology. So as we have the one session today, so the next session for emerging technology will be on 24 July, the same day. You can attend both the sessions if you are interested. The ETT webinar will be starting at 10 a.m. I'm really sorry, there was a little mistake, I guess. So our certification webinar will be starting at 2:30 in the afternoon, and ETT webinar will be starting in the morning. So we'll be sharing all the details in the chat box. Please do check and just register yourself. Last but important announcement. Your feedbacks are very important to us. So we'll be sharing the feedback form during the session and at the end of the session. So before leaving, please do fill the feedback form. Based on these feedbacks, we'll be selecting 5 lucky winners and we'll be getting the Microsoft sponsored exam vouchers from our side. We'll be announcing the winners and please fill all the details properly. Also, one more important thing that our session is having time restrictions. So we have kept last 15 minutes for Q&A session. So you can ask your question at the end of the session. If by any chance the session, your questions will be remain unanswered because of the time restriction, you can put your question in the feedback form. We have kept a special comment section at the end of the form. So please do fill the form and just submit it. Thank you so much. From this, I'll just hand over mic to Mahendra sir. So you can continue from here. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Rupesh.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yep. So here we start. My name is Mahendra Shinde, and as you people already know me, I have done Microsoft certification trainings in past. Lots of training, including Azure DevOps AZ 400 training. And today's topic, we'll be discussing the security practices and built-in security tools in Azure DevOps. So before we proceed, I just want to know how many of you have worked with the DevOps or Agile practices or any of the Agile practices and DevOps? Anyone? Okay. 2, 3. 3 people have raised hands, 6 people. Okay, great. Okay, that's great. So I can see there are total 9 people who have raised their hands. So DevOps is basically a practice which allows us to deliver quality software or quality product at the end of each iteration to our customers. And in order to ensure the quality, we use several practices, several concepts, several tools to ensure that we are delivering a quality product at the end of every cycle. Please remember, DevOps is a generic concept, and Azure DevOps is actually the name of tool which provides end-to-end DevOps features and components for all of us. Azure DevOps is a tool from Microsoft. Rather, it is available as a installable software, as well as it's available as a software as a service, SaaS solution, both. So what we'll do now, we will first have a quick introduction to what is Azure DevOps from Microsoft. Then we will discuss the 4 quadrants of security in DevOps. We will then discuss how we can run the static code analysis using a third-party tool called SonarQube. Then we will also discuss how we can perform a package scanning by using White Source Bolt. These are the two different demos I'm going to show you in this today's session. And then we will discuss the next aspect of it, which is scanning the infrastructure with Azure Policy and Azure Monitor, which are basically tools available from Microsoft Azure. And finally, I have included one more additional topic here because I felt that containerization is getting a lot of momentum now, and many people and many developers and even operations people, they are delivering their application in form of containers, Docker containers or simple containerized applications. So I felt it is necessary that I also give you a very quick overview of how we can even scan the container images for all kind of vulnerabilities. Okay. So that's our agenda for today. Now, very first thing, Azure DevOps. Have anyone heard about Azure DevOps or Visual Studio Team Services or TFS? TFS is just the old name of it, or you can rather say Azure DevOps is just a rebranding of TFS. Azure DevOps is basically available in 2 flavors. Azure DevOps Server, that is installable software that you can install in your own device machine. And the other option is to use Azure DevOps as a SaaS service. It's a subscription-based service. And what is even great thing, you can sign up for Azure DevOps for free. Okay. You just have to create a new, or I would recommend you can just use your existing or new Outlook account or Hotmail account. Okay. And you can sign up for a free trial of Azure DevOps. This one requires your own hardware. This is for on-premise version. And this is cloud version. We will be using this version right now, but most of the features are exactly same in both version of Azure DevOps. Now, what are the services that Azure DevOps provide? A DevOps basically, now whenever people think about DevOps, there are few important workflows which are included in DevOps. May I know if you know any workflows that we use in DevOps, or that those are part of DevOps? I will give you a hint. All those workflows, their name begins with continuous. Can anyone give me an example of any 3 workflows? There are 3 primary workflows in DevOps, basically. Anyone?
Continuous integration and continuous deployment.
Yes, that's right. So the first one is continuous integration. Okay. Next one is continuous delivery. And next one is continuous deployment. these are three primary workflows in Azure DevOps. Oh, sorry, not Azure DevOps. These are the primary workflows in DevOps: continuous integration, delivery, and deployment. Okay. Other than this, please remember DevOps simply means a collaboration between development team as well as operations team. Do you know DevOps also include two important components or concepts for ops team? These are, number one, configuration management, which is actually assumed using desired state configuration, DSC. This is for ops team, by the way. And this is out of scope for us right now. And number two is infra as code. Okay. Treat your infrastructure as a code. These are the two, you can say, DevOps workflows or DevOps component for ops team. And these are the three components where basically developers pay more attention to. Anyway, but please remember these workflows, for all these workflows and more, Azure DevOps has some of its components. Now, for these three workflows, continuous integration, continuous delivery, and continuous deployment, Azure DevOps has a feature called Azure Pipelines. And for many remaining things, Azure DevOps has a very nice integration with some third-party tools. To give you an example, if you want to implement something like infrastructure as a code, you can integrate Azure DevOps with a third-party tool called Terraform. It's a tool, very popular tool used by ops team, okay, which is used to set up or create your application environment directly from a script. Similarly, there is another tool which you can integrate with Azure DevOps to actually achieve desired state configuration or configuration management or change management. It's called Ansible. These are the tools very popularly used by your ops team. And Azure DevOps has very good integration with both of them. Okay. Is there anyone from ops background, operations background here? Yes. Okay. Yash has mentioned he has worked with Puppet. So Yash, Puppet can also be integrated with Azure DevOps. Okay. Rather, all these configuration management tools can be integrated with Azure DevOps. Just give me a minute. Okay, so we have Azure Pipelines, which is Azure DevOps component that actually facilitates us to set up all these workflows, continuous integration, delivery, deployment. Yeah, I can see there is one question here. No, we have just started, Lucky. Okay, we have not yet, we are just in module number one, as you can see, just the introduction part as of now. Okay, what was this question?